I'm just about done finishing up a central AC maintenance on this Rheem Prestige system. We installed a bunch of these type of systems with this integrated control board after Hurricane Sandy in 2012 and 2013. This is one of them we still maintain. This is a 3-ton, the RAPM-036JEZ. We come here every year, we clean out the bottom, and we vacuum out. There's no need to rinse the coil. We acid washed it last year, hosed everything down, and I got my JB Just Better Climate Class Smart Probes connected to the suction liquid and our clamp-on probes, temperature probes, on both suction and discharge lines. My Fluke 902 FC clamp-on amp meter is on L1 or L2, one of the lines of voltage coming in. And we're waiting for that little seat to stop flashing. Once she stops flashing, we're gonna have a compressor turn on, a condenser fan motor, and we're gonna watch our startup amperage on the Fluke clamp-on amp meter. I got the JB Go version 2.0 app in standby mode, waiting for it to kick on. Oh yeah, also installed a new dual capacitor for the compressor and condenser fan motor. I'll show you the one that we took out in a minute. Didn't spike as much as I thought it would there. Now we do have an indoor ambient temperature of 67 degrees. It is currently 58 degrees, my outdoor air temperature. We're gonna let this stabilize for a minute, and then I'm gonna show you how we test the capacitor dynamically with the system running. So check it out, guys, stick around. You're not gonna wanna miss it. All right, to test the dual capacitor dynamically, I'm using the HVAC school ForTech Biteex app. And inside the app, once you get past the refrigeration technologies ad, we're gonna go to main menu, we're gonna go to tools, and we're gonna go to under load capacitor test. A little cocky right there. All right, and we're gonna use this instructional picture to show you how we're gonna do this. So first thing we're gonna do is we're gonna check the amperage on the wire going to the compressor, okay? And our wire going to the compressor is going to be, which wire is it gonna be? It's gonna be that purple wire, nope. Do-do-do, do-do-do. Yeah, we're gonna be that purple wire. All right, so let's go right there. All right, and we are at 6.6 amps. So let's type in that 6.6, the voltage across the capacitor. We're gonna go from common to Herm. Okay, I'm gonna try to carefully do this for you. There is common, and there is, come on guys, get in there. And there is Herm, 372.5. All right, 372.5. And I know this is rated at a 45. We're gonna calculate that. And look, it is. There it is. Right now we are reading at 47.01, the calculated microfarads with a 4.46 deviation. Look at that, dynamically, right? So that was the compressor. Let's check now the condenser fan motor. Back to amperage. The brown wire is our condenser fan motor. All right, and we are at 0.6. So it's 0.6 in there. 2.6. I'm gonna do a voltage across the capacitor. Let's put this back into reading volts AC. Okay, and we're gonna go to there to there. Okay, common and fan, 336. Let's do 335.7. 335.7, and I know it's a 5. Calculate. Ooh, it's reading 4.74. The capacitor is 5 to 10%, which is low, which could generally be considered acceptable, may vary by company policy. And that is how you do an underload capacitor test. Let me give you a tech tip on this Friday morning. When you swap out a capacitor, don't just assume that it's good out of the box. Do a test on it before you put it in, or test it dynamically with the systems running. You can document your results on the work order, and it just gives you that much more peace of mind, and you're also delivering more value to the end user, your client, the most important person out of the whole picture. That's them and their comfort cooling.